Okay, I'm going to bring the March 7th meeting to order. Commissioner Campidelli and Natasha Yakalev are present. I can't pronounce her name to save my life. Anyway, we are audio and video recording, so you know. And if there is any public comment at this time, we'd like to take it now. Seeing none, we're going to move on to item number 3, application for entertainment license at the Freckled Fox Cafe, Inc., DBA, Freckled Fox Cafe, 1 North Main Street, Florence, Kitty Jondrow. Jondrow?
Yeah, Jondrow.
Hey, how are you?
Hi, how are you?
Good. Tell us a little bit about what you got going on, please.
So we're just looking to have maybe some poetry reading, some acoustic music. Some authors come in, do some books reading for the kids. We're not looking to have any electric music or anything. We have apartments above us, so for noise, you know, we're not looking to do that.
Okay, timing, like what's just during your hours of operation?
Oh, well, the latest we'd probably be is 9 o'clock, because we won't be there past 10. Again, the people above us. Mm-hmm. But we're only open till 6 on Thursday and Friday right now.
Okay.
And we're just doing the weekday because we're not open on Sunday.
Right.
So it's whatever kind of comes about. Yeah. That's what we're trying to do. Maybe when we do our Sunday brunch, then we'll do our Sunday entertainment. But
right.
Kind of looking for things like that.
Okay. No, you covered it.
Like to make a motion?
I would. I'll make a motion to approve the application for entertainment license for the Freckled Fox Cafe at 1 North Main Street in Florence.
Great. Thank you.
Second. All in favor?
Aye.
Thanks.
Thank you.
Thanks.
Be safe.
Yes,
you too.
It was nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
Hey, good luck.
Yeah.
What are you calling?
We're on Florence Island. We're
in number 4, application for short-term liquor licenses, Greater Northampton Chamber of Commerce. May 4th, 2018, 6 to 10:30 p.m. at Strong Avenue parking lot, chamber auction fundraiser, all alcohol. And September 12th, 2018, 5 to 7, Coldwell Banker, Upton Massamount, 112 Main Street networking event, wine and malt. And December 5th, 2018, 5 to 7, Thorns Marketplace, 150 Main Street networking event, wine and malt. That's it. Can you state your name for the record, please?
Sure. Suzanne Beck. I'm representing the applicant, the Greater Northampton Chamber of Commerce.
Great. Thank you. You want to tell us a little bit about these?
Sure. So the May 4th event is an event that we've held. This will be the fifth year at the Eastside Grill, where we take over the restaurant on Friday night and put a big tent in the East Strong Avenue parking lot. We work with the mayor's office and the parking commission if necessary to secure the parking lot. It's from 6 o'clock. The event officially starts at 6:30. People typically arrive a little before that, or can arrive a little bit before that, and it closes at 10. We've been careful about letting our abutters know about the event. I think the first, and now we have the Homestead Restaurant, which is replace Ibiza, but Ibiza folks are still involved with that, so we'll talk to them again. We always talk to the local, we always talk to just to make sure that we're kind of covering the bases with them. And we have offered, because that was the biggest issue, was the displacement of parking, and access for their customers. So we now offer the valet parking service that we offer to our guests, we offer to their customers as well, and we'll give them a notice that they can post in their window so people are prepared.
Great.
Yeah.
Okay, and the other two are just business as usual, same
networking events, 5 to 7. Yeah, beer and wine. We average 125 people at most of our Arrive at 5 events, and happy to answer any questions. I also brought Deb with me. Actually, she was supposed to. We were supposed to be reversed, because you might have questions about Eastside. It's a much bigger event on May 4th than you might have
I've actually attended.
Wait, is it the same setup as usual?
Yeah,
it's tent outside and it's cordoned off, and yeah, you guys always do a nice job keeping it separate from passerby, so I don't have questions about that event.
Okay. Great.
Do I need a motion for you to do that, Annie? Yes, okay. I'll make a motion to approve the application for short-term liquor license for the Greater Northampton Chamber of Commerce event on May 4th in the Strong Avenue parking lot. This is an all-alcohol license.
Second that, all in favor?
Aye. And I will make a second motion to approve the application for short-term liquor licenses, again for the Greater Northampton Chamber of Commerce, for a networking event on September 12th at Coldwell Banker Upton Massamont at 112 Main Street.
Second that, all in favor?
Aye. And a third motion to approve the application for short-term liquor license for the Chamber of Commerce networking event on December 5th at Florence Marketplace at 150 Main Street.
Second that, all in favor?
Aye.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you. Nice to see you guys.
Yes.
Take care.
Bye-bye. Are you done now?
Almost.
Well, remember that was just so.
Oh, that's right.
So I'm like, do you have your plow?
All right.
Bye.
Bye. Bye. Are you walking back to me?
I'll put my car in the garage. I'll give you a ride.
Oh, no.
Really?
Yeah.
So, I
spoke about 20 minutes ago. They were supposed to receive a copy of the bond today. Apparently there was an issue with the paperwork. Something had been inadvertently left out of the bond. It wasn't the applicant's fault, so it wasn't anything on Sakura. She said that it should be going up by the end of day today. They're in California, so they're about 3 hours behind. She said it should be delivered to her office by FedEx tomorrow. So, she said she did say this last week. It wasn't her fault. It was the bonding company. So, the license is expiring Friday. So we could take a chance that it'll be there, and then I'll reissue it with the December 31st expiration date. But if it doesn't, then we're stuck.
So she's meaning they don't have the right to serve until that bond.
Well, they've been serving, but we've just given them temporary expiration dates, and the expiration date for this one is March 9th, which is Friday.
So can we extend that? I mean, just if you know it's coming, rather than, I don't want to see them go, you know,
right,
15 or 20 days not being able to serve.
Right. So, right. So we can extend it until a few days after the next meeting, just in case.
Okay.
Otherwise, you would approve the renewal till the end of the year, but I don't want to do that maybe without having the paperwork.
Yeah, I think we should just forward it to our next meeting until after that.
And then in the meantime, if I get that paperwork, then I can issue it with the December 31st expiration date.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Hopefully tomorrow, but you never know.
All right, so you need a motion?
Yes.
To
extend
what's our date next meeting?
April 4th.
All right. So we want to go to, you know, a week beyond that?
Maybe just like the 6th, which is that Friday.
Okay.
And we need to, the common vic too. They have a common vic. So we need to extend the expiration for the common vic and the liquor.
Okay. All right. So I'm going to make a motion to extend the liquor license and the common vic for Alchan Inc. DBA Sakura Buffet until April 6th, pending receipt of bond, is it?
Yeah, wage bond.
The wage bond.
I second the motion.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Thank you. All right, request approval for seasonal liquor license renewals pending receipt of all appropriate documents. A is Hampshire Franklin Hamden Agricultural Society Beer Hall. B is, liquor license number 13. License 75, Hampshire Franklin Hamden Agricultural Society, Enfield. C is license number 140, Lawrence Pine Bar. D is license 82. Veracruz Foods, DBA Veracruz on. E is license number 96. Saint Talon Inc. as Asian Taste, DBA Asian Taste. And F, license number 112, Frankie Wallwood Memorial Park, DBA Pines Theater. G, license number 136, Mosaic Cafe Inc., DBA Mosaic Cafe. So tell us about this one, please.
So the seasonal license renewals came in from the ABCC. They have to be signed in the month of March. So I'm just requesting that you approve them handing all of their appropriate documents, which went out the last day in February. So that way, because their season starts April 15th for seasonal, so that only gives, if we were to approve them next meeting, it's just not enough time for them to get their license because they have to order the proof of the license.
Sure.
So once I get all of their documents, then I can, so basically when they bring them in, I can issue them then, so it's not like more mailings or having them come down again.
Okay. So just, like you said, we'll just approve pending.
Yeah, contingent upon liquor liability, workers' comp, the renewals, the payment, inspections, and the fair wage.
Okay. All right. You have any questions?
I don't.
Would you like to make that motion?
Sure. I'll make a motion to approve the processing of the seasonal liquor license renewals pending receipt of appropriate documents for Hampshire Franklin and Hamden Agricultural Society Beer Hall, Hampshire Franklin and Hamden Agricultural Society Infield, Florence Pie Bar, Veracruz Foods, Sang Ta Wan Asian Taste, Frank Newell Memorial Park, and the Mosaic Cafe.
I second that. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Thank you. Approval number 7, approval minutes from February 14th meeting. Did you have a chance to look at those?
I did.